Hello? Now, if your right eye offends you, I want you to tear it out and fling it away.
That's the most ridiculous thing I've ever heard.
Now look, it's better for you to lose one part of your body than for the whole of it to be thrown into hell.
Yeah, but she's gotta be back.
Since when?
About a week back. Master, let me chastise this vixen.
Why don't you just get back there? Now, if your right hand offends you, I want you to cut it off and fling it away.
Oh, come on.
Now look, it's better for you to lose one part of your body than for the whole of it to be thrown into hell. You have learned that they were told. An eye for an eye and a tooth for a tooth. But what I tell you is this. Never set yourself against a man who wrongs you. So, if someone slaps you on the right cheek, turn and offer him your left.
Oh, Jesus Christ.
Slowly I turned, step by step, inch by inch.
Hello? Oh, yes, of course, yeah. It's for you. It's your father.
Now, if a man sues you for your shirt...
Oh, treat! Famous quotation! Oh my god, man.
How about love?
sun, set and rise on good and bad alike, and sends the rain on the honest and dishonest. Now, if you greet only those who greet you, what reward do you expect? Surely the tax gatherers do as much as that. And if you love only those who love you, where's the extraordinary in that? Even the heathen do as much. No, your goodness must have no bounds, just as your heavenly Father's goodness has no limits. But take care that you do not make a show of your religion before men, because if you do, no reward awaits you in the kingdom of my Father. When you do some act of charity, don't announce with a flourish of trumpets, as the heathen do in the streets and the synagogues. No, when you do some act of charity, don't let your left hand know what your right hand is doing. Your good deed must be a secret.
It's a secret. Okay, what the good master is trying to tell us is that when God tells a secret on us, the angels, they write it down in this big...
No. Your heavenly Father, who sees what's done in secret, he will what?
Reward you!
There was once a rich man who dressed in purple and in the finest linen.
That's me!
And every day feasted in the greatest magnificence. At his gate lay a poor man
named Lazarus, who would have been glad to have satisfied his hunger with the scraps from the rich man's table.
Oh my God, it's good.
Even the doggy doggies used to come and lick his open running sores.
Well, one day, the poor man died. And was carried away by angels. To be with Abraham. Oh, the rich man also died. And was buried in Hades.
Hello.
Where he was in torment. He looked up and there, far away, was Abraham, with Lazarus close beside him.
Oh, Father Abraham, have pity on me. Send Lazarus to dip the tip of his finger in water to cool my tongue, for I am in agony in this fire.
Remember, my child, all good things fell to you while you were on earth, and all the bad to Lois.
Lazarus!
Abraham, nice to meet you.
And now it is he who has consolation here, and you were in agony there. But that ain't all. There was this great chasm fixed between us, and no one from your side wants to cross a can, and no one from our side wants to cross a can either. You know, you guys can stop. Then, Father Abraham, send Lazarus to my father's house, where I have five brothers, to warn them, so that they too may not come to this place of torment.
They've got Moses and the prophets. Let them listen to them.
But if someone were to rise from the dead, then they would listen.
Look, if they ain't gonna listen to Moses and the prophets, they ain't gonna listen to anybody, even if somebody should.
Rise from the dead.